when anybody wrote anything in the New Testament that said that what Jesus would do would give every human being the option at righteousness or the option at eternal life, there is no prophet, no prophet that would have ever said that, because the prophets knew everybody, the entire planet, was condemned by the deeds of one man, and the prophets knew the deed of that one man, if it were resolved, everyone would be righteous and holy. The prophets understood that, clearly understood that, and that's exactly what they prophesied. Even if they hadn't understood it, that's what they prophesied. But I think they did understand it. I think the prophets of old understood this. I think it was clear to them that only one man was going to completely reverse the action and deed of another man, thereby freeing us from all the law, because the application of the law came because we were sinners. The law did not make any man a sinner. The law never made anybody a sinner. You gotta get that, folks. Breaking a law never made you a sinner. Never made anybody a sinner before the cross, and especially after the cross, because the law was done away with. Why was it done away with? Its application to sinners. There aren't any sinners anymore. The law was given for sinners.
And a good case could be made for the fact that Jesus himself broke the law. But the New Testament writings say that he was tempted in all ways.
Right.
And a temptation is a thought, certainly.
Yes, absolutely.
Jesus taught himself that if you thought it, you violated the law.
Yeah. And, well,
it says he was without sin.
Yes.
And so in the same way that Jesus was without sin, because he was not born by virtue of the seed of Adam, of the seed of man, we have no sin, because we have been born again in Christ.
By the Spirit, 2,000 years ago, the entire planet.